So today is going to be a wombo combo of lots of different inoculations. We're going to be just looking at everything that we have today and seeing what needs to be done. Pretty much just upkeep. So this is stuff that you would tend to see on a daily basis back at home. This is what I do in the morning, just making sure that they're like okay and that they're fine. Checking for contamination every day, just so you can know like what it looks like at every stage. I'm gonna put this mic on because the flow hits kind of loud, and then we're gonna get started. Let's do it.
First up is our Ganoderma sinense that we made in the last video or the video before that. It's very ready, as you can see, compared to the video shown on the side. It used to be all brown with the substrate and the grain spawn, but now the mycelium have jumped off the grain and colonized all of the substrate. So I'm just removing all the air from the bag, taping it down, and then I'm going to flip it over just so the weight of the block kind of presses all the air out. And I'm going to take a sterile knife and cut a slit through the bag. And I'm just going to give it some fresh air and let it sit out here and allow it to fruit. There's going to be a little bit of metabolites building up on the bottom, but that's totally normal. Just make sure that it stays mostly clear.
Sinense that we dropped in, and it was like a couple videos ago. Looking real nice. We dropped it right on the surface. We're going to let it work its way through. It's not at the bottom yet, quite yet, but it's working on it. Looks good. So real quick, I got this multipileum in the mail. This is a Ganoderma that really likes to go spindly, and they like to call it like an antler Reishi because it antlers out instead of conking. And conking is when the mushroom comes up like a shelf, and that's when it typically starts to spore. Well, this one will keep coming up. We already used this one time before. So we're going to move on to something else, like this Ganoderma sinense that's been growing in this cup since we first touched it. As we open the cup, and you see it's actually touching the top now. That's technically our first fruit in here in the lab. Ain't that cool? You see the tiny other fruiting bodies in there? See how the cup is sweating? That's perfect conditions. I'm gonna put them right back in there. You know, actually, let's do this. I know this is a sterile cup. For sure. I've never actually like done it like this, but it makes sense. So my goal is pretty much to figure out a bunch of consistent ways to grow a bunch of fungi in a small environment. And so that's what we're going to be doing. This should provide some good conditions for it. The temperature of the room will help this evaporate, and that will cause condensation on the walls, which will make this one to grow across the entire cup. Hopefully we can get it to like spindle and take over the whole cup, but you know, it's just a little experiment. Anyone could do this. This is super simple. That's just agar with mycelium on there. Inside the cup, we let it colonize, introduce a little air. Then it started pinning up because it likes the high CO2 that it offputs. And then we just put that cup in a cup with some water and put some holes in it. Easy stuff. Our sidewalk reishi with the casing layer on top is not quite ready yet, but you can see it's fully colonized it, but not in a way that I would like to expose it. Because if I did, it'd probably spike up over here and only grow on one side. But if I, maybe if I just open this real quick, introduce a little air in there, and get the other sides to spike up and get some even growth. I think I'm going to put this inside of a bag, kind of the same idea as having a cup in a cup. So here's a peek at the sidewalk reishi that we did with the casing layer in the jar. And you can see that's ready to go. So just by opening the jar, we just started the pinning process because now there's fresh air in there. So I'm going to let them form up and then we'll come back to it. We'll do the same thing with this one. It probably looks about the same. Well, you can see there's a skin that the reishi likes to form. So this is why people make reishi leather. This is starting. It's actually is holding the top all on its own because of the skin. And the reason it did that is because it's reaching out for the air. Ain't that awesome? So we're gonna flip that back in there. All that exposure is gonna make it pin up in there, and now we have a little window view inside because we tore the skin. It's the lion's mane. This is ready too. You can see the substrate's here. There's air here. They're so ready to go. They've already crawled up the wall. They're going for the air. So we're going to give them a little bit. That's lion's mane. You can see it pinning up in there. And so since we opened this jar, this is going to entice the pinning even more. So we're pretty much just waking all the mycelium up. We're like, get up, it's time to fruit. Oh, this is some really good coverage. This is more of the sidewalk reishi. Cased it with cocoa. Some good coverage. I'm gonna move this one into a bag. This looks really good. And we'll just let it hang out in there, and we've got a front row seat to them fruiting. And we could just fill the shelves up with these and watch them grow. We don't have to worry about them sporing all over the place. And they'll just keep wanting to go up because of this, there's so much air coming from the top and from this filter patch. So we're going to do a lot of these. I'm going to do some experiments to see, like, which way would be the best for which species, but we're gonna do this before we get too deep into the grow tent. Because not everybody wants to invest the space or the money in a grow tent, but anyone could buy like a Ziploc bag at home or get some of these grow bags here and just do some experiments in their closet or something. So this is accessible to everyone. You could do this in a lab, you could do this at home. But yeah, guys, thanks for hanging out with me. I'm going to go through a few more of these before I go and just tidy them up. And I'll see you guys next time.
Hey, Microdex here. If you guys want to support the channel and save some money on some plant and fungi supplies, go and check out the Plant Cell Technology Store and use the code Microdex to save 10%.